Dear students, welcome to English video lessons. Happy to see you all. How are you? Are you happy? Are you celebrating your life? Good. Today, we are going to see what is vocabulary and why it is important in our life. Vocabulary is a collection of words used in a language. Why is vocabulary important? It improves reading comprehension. It is important for language development. It helps to communicate ideas. It helps to express yourself in writing. Your vocabulary level predicts your occupation. So, you should improve your vocabulary. Every day you have to learn many words and practice it in your day-to-day life. English is an international language. It is spoken all over the world. So, you have to learn lots of words in English. Today, let's move on to the vocabulary section in Unit 3. Are you interested to play a word game? Good. Let's play a word game. I'll tell a word. You have to go through the lesson and spot the words which mean the same. I will mention the paragraph also where the meaning of the word is available. Let's start. The first word is profession. Profession. You go through the first para in lesson 3. Have you found out? Yes. Profession means career. If you get all the words correct, you are excellent students. Okay. So, be active. The second word is sorrowful. Search it in the second para. Sorrowful. Yes, gloomy. Sorrowful means gloomy. Then, decency. In para 5. Decency. That means nobility. Decency, nobility. The next word is hijacked. You are familiar with the word hijacked, I think. So, it is in the para 8. Hijacked means commandeered. Commandeered. The next word, motivation. Motivation. Found out? Yes. Encouragement. Motivation, encouragement. Then, serious in para 10. Serious. Severe. Okay, good. The last word is significant. You search it in para 13. Significant means important. How many of you have all correct? Okay, you are excellent. Very good. Let us go on to the next exercise. So, first we learn the meanings. Now, we are going to learn some opposites. Okay, are you ready? Yes. Go through the lesson and spot the words which is opposite to the given words. The first one, rare. You all know the meaning of rare. What's the opposite of rare? It is in para 1. Find out quickly. What's the opposite of rare? Prevalent. Rare, prevalent. Next, primitive. Primitive. In para 6. What's the meaning of primitive? Unsophisticated. So the opposite will be sophisticated. Next word, fiction. Fiction. Fiction meaning unreality. Opposite, in para 7 it is given fact. Fiction, fact. The next word is fearful. Fearful. In para 8, the opposite is there. Interpret. We have already learned the meaning of interpret, bold and daring. The opposite of fearful is bold and daring or interpret. Fifth word is benign. Benign means harmless. It is in para 11. The opposite is given in para 11. What's the opposite? Malignant. Benign, malignant. Then, diffidence. Diffidence means doubt. So the opposite will be, it is given in para 11, confidence. Diffidence, confidence. Boredom. The next word is boredom. You all hate this word, no? So the opposite will be, it is in para 12, amusement, enjoyment. The last word, criticize. It is given in para 13. Go through it quickly. The opposite of criticize is appreciate. We all want to be appreciated rather to be criticized. Yes. Well, let us revise again. The opposite of rare, prevalent. Primitive, sophisticated. Fiction, fact. Fearful, interpret. Benign, malignant. Diffidence, confidence. Boredom, amusement. Criticize, appreciate. Very good. How many of you got all correct? Very, very good. Keep it up. Let's pass on to the next exercise. Distinguish the meaning of the words. There are three words given. First one, career, carrier, courier. Career, carrier, courier. What do you mean by career? You see the picture? The teacher is teaching. Teaching is her career. So another word for career is profession. Profession. Career means profession. The next word, carrier. What do you see in the picture? The cycle has a carrier. Okay, a thing that carries, carrier. Then courier. Courier, a company that transports commercial packages. A company or an employee of the company that transports the commercial packages. Have you all understood the difference between these words? Okay, good. Carrier, carrier, courier. Next, patient, patience, patent. Patient, patient, who is a patient? One who is under a medical care. Patient. Patience, do you have patience in your life? Yes, it's a virtue. If you have patience, you will be respected by all. So patience is a rare virtue. Be patient. We have to learn to be patient. The next, patent. What do you mean by patent? It's a government authority given to an inventor to sell goods, etc. So, patent, rights given to an inventor. Can you distinguish these words? Again, patient, patience, patent. Next, accident, incident, incidents. You have all seen some accidents, no? Accident means unfortunate incident. It is also an incident. Accident, unfortunate incident. What do you mean by an incident? It is an event. Incident, incidents, event. That means event. The next one, scrapping, scrapping, scrubbing. In the first word, only single P is available. Scrapping. Scrapping means sound of something, scrapping. Sound of something, scrapping. Scrapping, that waste materials. Scrappings means waste materials, the discarded materials like that. Scrubbing, rubbing hard with the brush. Scrubbing means rubbing hard with the brush. Have you understood the difference? Good. Scrapping, scrapping, scrubbing. The next one, accept, accept, expect. Accept. Accept means consent to receive. You are willing to receive it. That is the meaning of accept. Accept. You see in the picture, there are four people, only three people say yes. One says no. So, except one, all three people say yes. So, except means not included. Then, expect. You always make mistakes with these two words. Except, expect while writing. You have to be very careful when writing these words. Except spelling E-X-C-E-P-T. Then expect. E-X-P-E-C-T. So what do you expect from others? We would always expect good things from others. What do you mean by expect? Likely to happen in your future. Likely to happen. The next word, lesson. You all are learning lessons every day. So what's meaning for the word lesson? L-E-S-S-O-N. The teacher teaches a lesson. L-E-S-S-O-N. S-S-O-N. Then, lesson, L-E-S-S-E-N. What do you mean by lesson? Lesson means diminish, diminishing, becoming less. That is lesson. The opposite of lesson is increase, expand, enlarge. The meaning of lesson is diminish. Then, lesson. You see this picture? Your hand is wounded. It has an injury. So, lesion is a wound or an injury. That is lesion. Have you understood the difference between these words? Lesson, lesson, lesion. Next, severe, sever, sever. Severe, sever, sever. Severe weather, that is intense, the severe weather. We couldn't tolerate such weather, severe weather. The wind is blowing heavily, it's raining heavily, these and all severe weather. So intense, severe means intense. Sever, sever, that is divide by cutting. Sever means divide by cutting. Sewer, underground channel for waste water. Sewer, underground channel for waste water. You can understand by seeing these pictures. Good. Then, race, rise, rise, race. When a teacher asks a question and asks you, how many of you know the answer? Suddenly you will raise your hands. So that is raise. Raise means lift up. Raise means lift up. Then rise. You have all watched sunrise. No? So rise means go up. Rise means go up. Then rise. R-I-C-E. R-I-S-E. It is used as a verb. R-I-C-E. It is used as a noun. So, rice, Indian food. Then, quiet, quiet, quit. Quiet, Q-U-I-E-T. This is a familiar word. Every day you would hear this word. Keep quiet, keep quiet. So, quiet means making no noise. That is quiet. Another similar word, quiet, but different spelling, Q-U-I-T-E, that is very completely, that means very completely. How was the exam? The exam was quite hard, that is completely hard. So, quite, that means completely. Okay, quit. If someone asks you to quit the bad habits, to quit the job, that means give up, give up. You see this picture, a man quits his job and goes away. The last one, final, finale, feline, final, final year, final solution. You might have heard these words, final, okay, end. What is finale? That is the end of some performance. That is a performance of a show or a piece of music. That is finale. That is the difference, okay? Finale, the performance, the end of performance of a lost piece. Feline, it's a cat. Feline means cat. Good. You have understood well. Students, be active. Okay. Today you are going to learn many words in English. You are so lucky. The next exercise, form a phrase with the following pairs of nouns. You have already learned what is a noun. What's a noun? The name of everything. Okay. What's a verb? Action words or verbs. What's an adjective? Adjectives or qualifying words. What's an adverb? A word that describes the quality of a verb. Okay. So here, two nouns are given. You have to make a phrase out of these two nouns. So how can you make it a phrase? Both words are nouns. So in order to make it a phrase, you have to change the first word into an adjective form. What's the first one? Muscle plus pain. Muscle is a noun, pain is a noun. How can you change the word muscle into an adjective? Muscle, muscular. So the phrase is muscular pain. For example, poverty is a noun. Change into adjective, poor. Like that, you have to change the noun into adjective form. Second one, skeleton plus system. Anyone knows the answer? Raise your hands. Skeleton plus system, skeletal system. Third one, nerve plus disorder. I think you know the adjective form of nerve. Nerve, nervous. So, nervous disorder. Then, digestion plus enzymes. That is digestive. The adjective form of digestion is digestive. So, digestion plus enzymes, digestive enzymes. Next one, surgery plus instruments. So, surgery. What's the adjective form of surgery? Surgical. Surgical instruments. Next, agony plus experiences. Agony. Agony, agonizing. Agonizing experiences. Then, glory plus victory. Glory, glorious. Glorious victory. Then, fancy plus idea. Fanciful idea. You like it? Fanciful idea. Emotion plus song. Emotional song. Sense plus issue. Sensitive issue. Good. Let us repeat. Muscle plus pain. Muscular pain. Skeleton plus system. Skeletal system. Nerve plus disorder. Nervous disorder. Digestion plus enzymes. Digestive enzymes. Surgery plus instruments. Surgical instruments. Agony plus experiences. Agonizing experiences. Glory plus victory. Glorious victory. Fancy plus idea. Fanciful idea. Emotion plus song. Emotional song. Sense plus issue. Sensitive issue. Very good. The next exercise. Fill in the blanks with the words given in brackets. You have already learned these words. You are so familiar with these words. Yes. Profound, that means very great. Amusement, enjoyment. Confidence, that is hope. Agony, physical and mental suffering. Solace, comfort, intrepid, bold and daring, disfigured, spoiled in appearance, perforated, that is damaged. Okay, let us read the sentences and fill in the blanks with the correct words. First one, theatrical plays were a main source of dance before the advent of television. What's the answer? Theater. We go to theater for amusement. Yes. Theatrical plays were a main source of amusement before the advent of television. Okay. Second sentence, the dance warriors of the Spartan army marched into battle against a powerful enemy. Warriors. What's the main quality of a warrior? Bold and daring. What's the word for bold and daring? Intrepid. So, the intrepid warriors. Correct answer is the intrepid warriors. Next. The dash of parents finally came to an end when their lost child was found with the help of police. The dash of parents. So their child is missing. How they would feel? They would be painful. So the agony of parents. The agony of parents finally came to an end when their lost child was found with the help of police. Fourth one, social media has brought about a dash impact on the lives of millennials. Social media has brought about a dash impact. Do you know the answer? Profound, very great. Profound means very great. So, social media has brought about a profound impact on the lives of millennials. Fifth one, the tires of the car got dash. When the vehicle rolled over, the rusted nails scattered on the road. You imagine the situation. The tires of the car got dash when the vehicle rolled over, the rusted nails scattered on the road. Perforated, that is damaged. Okay. Then, Thomas Alva Edison did not lose his dash even after facing a series of experimental failures in his quest to discover tungsten. So, he did not lose his hope. Another word for hope, confidence. Seventh one, many victims of the pipeline explosion in an oil refinery were left permanently victims. They are victims. So what would have happened? They were left permanently disfigured. Disfigured. The last sentence, the old lady found dash in the company of the children in the neighborhood. The old lady found solace. Solace means comfort. Okay. You have understood all the words and filled in the blanks. Very good. Now, let me say a word. You have to say its other forms. If I say a word in noun form, you have to say its verb form, adjective form and adverb form. First one, amusement, that is a noun. What's the verb form? Amuse. Amuse. Adjective? Amusing. Adverb? Most of the adverbs ends with ly. So, amusingly. Appreciate. Appreciate. It's a verb. So, noun? Appreciation. Adjective? Appreciative. Adverb?
Appreciatively.
Next, success. Success? Do you know whether it is a noun or verb? It's a noun. Success is a noun. Verb form? Succeed. Adjective? Successful. Adverb? Successfully. Then pride. Pride. Is it a verb or a noun? Pride? It's a noun.
Verb? Also pride.
Adjective also proud. Adverb? Proudly. Then hope. Hope can be used as a noun and also as a verb in the same way. Hope, hope. Adjective? Hopeful. Adverb? Hopefully. You have done a good job. You have learned many words. Okay. Really, you will be rewarded. You listened patiently. Thank you so much.
நிகழ்ச்சியை பற்றிய தங்களின் மேலான கருத்துக்களை கீழ்கண்ட முகவரிக்கு கடிதம் மூலமாகவோ மின்னஞ்சல் மூலமாகவோ குறுஞ்செய்தி மூலமாகவோ தெரியப்படுத்தலாம். அனுப்ப வேண்டிய முகவரி சிறப்பு அலுவலர் கல்வி தொலைக்காட்சி 8 தளம் அண்ணா நூற்றாண்டு நூலகம் காந்தி மண்டப சாலை கோட்டூர்புரம் சென்னை 685 தொலைபேசி எண் 7824001500